Your credit score and credit report are two different things and are very important, especially nowadays if you're trying to gain wealth through real estate. Now, in this video, I'm going to break the two down for you so you can get a better understanding of the two and also give you some tips to help raise that score. Let's go. What's up, everybody? This is your boy, Jacques. If you're new to this channel, I'm a licensed realtor and mortgage loan originator in the state of Florida. Now, my goal on this channel is to help you gain wealth through real estate and also help tackle those questions that you might have. So let's jump into the video. Now, before you guys go out and get a car or before you even get a house, as you know, your credit has to be on point. Your credit score also affects if you're going to get a credit card, the interest that you pay, and sometimes the job that you get as well. Now, a lot of people don't understand the difference between a credit report and a credit score. So let me break down the two for you. Now, for the credit report, it's basically a history of all your accounts and payments across all credit products, which can include student loans, car loans, mortgage, and credit cards. So basically, it's the summary and life of your credit. Now, your credit report is handled and maintained by three different bureaus. Those three bureaus are Equifax, TransUnion, and Experian. Now, if you haven't done so already, don't forget, you can also get a free copy of your credit report once a year. So definitely look into it. I highly advise for you to look at it at least once a year. Make sure there's no negative items on there that you're not aware of or inaccuracies. And also, did you know that there's a fourth bureau? A lot of people are aware of this. The fourth bureau is actually named Enovis. Now, Enovis provides ID verification data to assist with fraud detection and prevents and help you freeze a consumer report if you request it. Now, my question of the day is, everyone always hears about the three credit report agencies, the three main ones, Equifax, TransUnion, Experian. Did you know that there was a fourth one? Drop your answers in the comment section below. Again, with your credit report, it's basically a summary. It has all your positive trade lines, all your account history, and basically look to see if there's anything on there that should or should not be there, and it should have your full, complete credit profile. Now that we got the credit report out the way, let's go over your credit score. So your credit score basically is a number that allows lenders to see how well you manage your final obligations you had in the past. Also, if you haven't done so already, make sure you click on the link above. I go into full detail on how to increase your credit score and also give you a lot of tips on my last video. So make sure you watch that one as soon as you can. Now, without going into too much detail, because I did that in my last video, I'll just go over the credit score just real quickly again. So again, 35% of your credit score is your payment history. Basically, keep your payments on time. Make sure those credit cards and other things that you pay are on auto pay, so that way you don't miss a beat. Now, the other 35% are types of credit, new credit, and the average length of credit card history that you have. Now, another big chunk of your credit score is your credit utilization. Basically, try to pay as much as you can down on those credit cards and keep it as low as possible. Pay it off if you can. I don't even want you to pay a dime of interest if you have to. Now, I'm gonna have to say this part for the video. Please, whenever you're looking at your credit score, use something like myfico.com or go to the actual bureaus. Please don't use Credit Karma. Credit Karma does not give you an actual FICO score. Now, I know everyone's in love with Credit Karma because it gives you a free credit score and things like that, but just want to let you know, no lender uses a Credit Karma score. So basically, you're just wasting your time looking at the number. Yeah, it may look pretty, and when you're ready to buy your home or whatever you're going to use it for, you'll be very surprised and shocked when you go to the lender. All those months, maybe years that you've been looking at that credit score, it's not accurate. And the bureaus basically maintain and collect the same information, but how they report them is different. That's why when you're on three different bureaus, you may have the same or similar information, but the scores are radically different. One reason for that is sometimes credit card companies only report to a specific bureau or bureaus. So with that being said, sometimes you may see a score being inflated and it's not showing up on the other credit reports. So sometimes that can affect your score as well. Now also in the description box below, you can increase your FICO score with Experian Boost. Now, results may vary, so make sure you see the website, the App Store, or Experian.com for details. But I had a couple of people use it and actually increased their credit score by a few points. So again, just to recap, make sure you guys look at your credit report. Make sure there's nothing wrong on that credit report. Look at it every single year because you're given a free credit report anyways. Make sure you utilize that and take advantage of that. Now, within that credit report, there's your credit score. Make sure with the tips that I gave you in the last video and also in this video as well, make sure the credit utilization is down. make sure you pay those credit card bills on time and don't open up any new accounts as well. Another quick tip, if you're out shopping and sometimes we love to go to these department stores and they want to go ahead and give you an extra 20-30% off, make sure you don't open up that credit card because that will bring the age of your credit card history down, which can then hurt you as well. Also, that credit card might not have a big line of credit. That's also going to hurt your credit utilization. So try to resist that urge and temptation to get that card. Just walk away. And that way, if you're trying to buy a home, car, or whatever you're going to use your credit for in the future, you have the best and highest score possible. Now, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure you smash that like button if you learned something new. Make sure you subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. And make sure that notification bell is on. As always, I hope you guys have a great day, great week. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace. Don't you know?